does it feel being two people stuffed in one skin suit? Being friends with a Gemini is like watching someone play a solo game of telephone. When a Gemini knows they messed up, they text their confession, followed by lol. Geminis think learning about something means skimming an article about it, and then they repeat choice lines like word for word and pretend it came from their own personal genius. Just because you read two peer-reviewed articles you found on Google doesn't make you well-versed. Geminis are so preoccupied with being the center of attention, they never get introspective. But they should. They have a lot of buried feelings to deal with, such as, my post got 1,000 likes, so why do I still feel like shit? Cancer. Cancers are annoyingly oversensitive crabs who can't take criticism. Cancers are so sentimental, they hold grudges just to keep past relationships alive in their heads. Cancers don't know that they can view Instagram memories without reposting them. They also don't know that no one wanted to watch that blurry concert video in 2018, and they definitely don't want to see it again now. How to seduce a Cancer? Exchange childhood photos. The great thing about Cancer is that they'll genuinely love you after only 2 weeks. Cancers are unnecessarily offended by people telling them info about their best friends as if they didn't already know. Also, Cancers are the kids who cried when it was their turn to find everyone else during hide and seek. Leo. Leos are attention-starved narcissists who never stop talking about themselves. Leos are charming until they use their powers of charisma to sweet-talk their way out of accountability. Newsflash. Being the center of attention also means being responsible for your actions. Here's a riddle for Leos. If no one paid attention to you, would you still act the same way? A Leo's memoir title is just their name in all caps. Leo's reedy, main character energy, so they treat everyone else like extras, and that's why it blows their mind when they realize someone else is human. A Leo will dump you if you're not photogenic enough. Conversely, if a Leo you love is showing you off, it's only because they just spotted their ex in the crowd. Virgo. Virgos are obsessive nitpickers, easily overwhelmed by imperfection. Spending time with a Virgo is like choosing death by 1,000 nitpicks. A Virgo will break up with you by sending you the Google Sheet pro-con list they used to make the decision. Hot tip for Virgos, multiple reference letters is not a replacement for human contact. And no one has time to read your multi-paragraph Tinder bio. It's actually a 5-paragraph essay. The first paragraph is like, in this essay, I'll prove that I have no sense of humor. Moreover, I will remember every little thing about you because I keep it in my notes app. You're like scrolling to the bottom, and then it's like, in conclusion, if you believe our relationship will serve a purpose and has the potential for a long-term future, please reach out. Libra. Libras are shameless flirts who have no idea how manipulative they are. Libra, your need to please everyone is probably your least pleasing quality. Nothing terrifies a Libra more than being disliked by literally anyone. Maybe that's why they flirt so much. You can find a Libra at the pet store trying to seduce the employees into giving them a kitten for free. They just flirt with everything in sight, especially if they're down and need an ego boost. You ask them about it and they're like, I'm testing the waters. And you're like, no, what you're actually doing is throwing a bunch of spaghetti at the wall and seeing what sticks. Dinner dates with Libras are the worst. They're like, I just love small plates. I get to snack and try all the things. You're like, there are no small plates here. They're like, okay, what are you getting? You're like, the fish or the chicken. They're like, me too. You're like, don't copy me. They're like, okay, I'll get the fish and you get the chicken and we can share. Libras are known for being indecisive, and that's because they are. In part, it's because they don't want to disappoint anyone, but waiting half an hour for them to make a decision is pretty disappointing. Scorpio. Scorpios are sex-obsessed instigators who live for drama, and if you tell them that, they'll take it as a compliment. Scorpios are really intense, like, really intense. Scorpios are still holding on to, like, fifth-grade heartbreak. Then they grow up and have adult crushes where, you know, they stalk you from afar and sneak into your bedroom at night to cut a lock of your hair. Then they, like, eat the hair and write you a letter that's a poem about how your hair is forever now, but they don't sign it with their name because that would be too pedestrian, and that's called dating a Scorpio. Scorpios are like death, sex secrets, that's it. They suck your secrets up through a straw. Every once in a while, I'll get a push notification that's like, so lucky to have found this teachable moment on your brave quest to unlocking your full potential. I realized something similar myself when I took peyote in Las Vegas for the second time. Then they're like, problem solved, now I'm bored. They run away because the conversation is past the 3-minute mark. Sagittarius sits up at night, fantasizing about purging everything they own and starting fresh. In the morning, they'll wake up and be like, my gut says no, but I think I'm gonna do it. Capricorn. Capricorns are self-righteous wet blankets obsessed with whack rules. Holy crap, are you guys okay? What are you feeling? Don't want to share? Okay. Date a Capricorn if you want to schedule sex a week in advance. This one's not a joke, it's just a fact. Maybe that's because they get off so hard on their to-do lists instead. Crossing something off a list is basically their kink. Newsflash, life is about more than getting promoted, marrying rich, and balancing your checkbook. When Capricorns are dating, they're like, no ambition, red flag. Limited potential, red flag. Still exploring hobbies and enjoying life, red flag. Finally, they're like, I choose this one, and it's this rich person with whom they have no emotional connection or shared interests, but they're like, I can make this work, without realizing that that's the actual red flag. You know a Cap likes you if they make time to see you more than once a month, and you know it's official if they add you as their beneficiary. Capricorn's bedtime routine is just them closing all of their tabs one by one. In short, Capricorns are basically unsexy Virgos. It's like a Virgo if you took out the sex drive and just stuffed in more work. Aquarius. Aquarians are unfeeling aliens who won't shut up about their ideas. Memoir title, How to Lose Friends and Alienate People. Dear Aquarians, being weird does not make you interesting. Just because you say yoinks doesn't mean you're special. Aquarians have a hard time connecting with people. They love people, but like in a clinical way. They like the idea of humanity more than they like actual humans. So they collect people like little specimens. They put their friends in little jars. They're like, this is my friend the orphan. This is my friend the acrobat. This is my famous friend. You're like, yeah, okay, cool, but they all suck. An Aquarius breaks up with you by introducing you as their friend until you're no longer sure you were ever dating. Conversely, if an Aquarius tells you they love you, congratulations, your Aquarius has learned that this is a phrase that humans express to each other when they experience a kind of fondness. They just don't know how to interact. So if they seem enlightened or emotionally available, they're probably just regurgitating shit from their therapist. Pisces. Pisces are tender flakes who live in their feelings. You know that friend that no one ever remembers whether they showed up or not? That's a Pisces. Communicates exclusively through telepathy, poetry, and meaningful eye contact. Pisces are in this constant, elaborate inner monologue of nonsensical illusion. A Pisces fantasizes about their dream wedding instead of